welcome to New Image Church.
Amen.
I don't know what's different about this morning, but I woke up a little early, and man, I had a praise on my mouth, and it reminded me of the scripture, the very last chapter of the book of Psalms. It says, praise ye the Lord. Praise God in his sanctuary. Praise him in the firmament of his power. Praise him for his mighty acts. Praise him according to his excellent greatness. Praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with the psaltery and the harp. Praise him with the timbrel and dance. Praise him with stringed instruments and organs. Praise him upon loud cymbals. Praise him upon the high sounding cymbals. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise ye, Lord.
All right.
I want to break a few things down in this. Y'all know how God works. Like, you read it and it's like, there ain't something else there. Praise him in the sanctuary. Yeah. What is the sanctuary? It's the place set apart, right? It's this house of God. All right. It said, praise him in the firmament.
Yeah.
When I studied the firmament,
come on now.
And that's the space between earth and heaven, right?
That's
everything that could happen. Everything, man. All right. We're going to go.
All right. Go ahead.
Praise him for his mighty acts. We don't have no problem with that one, right? But then he says, praise him according to his excellent greatness. All right, what I understood when I read that, it spoke to me. One of them is a response, right? Praise him according to his mighty acts. That's something I've seen. I praise him according to his excellence. That's who he is, y'all.
Amen. Amen.
There's a lot more I can say, but I want to say this. As y'all stand to your feet, we get ready to worship God. I want to say this. Man, this season we just walked through, that we're still in, sort of, you know, this whole thing has been rough, right? You could have died, man. Look around. Look at the statistics of how many people's died. You're still here. Right, and because you're still here, you all gotta pray.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so praise him with the stringed instruments. Praise him with the cymbals. Lord, we lift your name up this morning above every need, above every bad doctor's report, Lord God. But I thank you for who you are.
Yeah.
Inhabit our praises this morning. You said where two or three are here, are gathered in your name, you're here. Thank you for that, Father. Thank you for who you are.
Yeah.
Lord, your presence is the promise.
Yeah.
Thank you for that, Father. Thank you for who you said you would never leave us nor forsake us, Father. Thank you for that, Lord. God, I ask that you just be with us this morning. Lead us, guide us. Be with the praise and worship. Be with the pastor as he brings the word. Be with everyone in this house, Father. Lord, I expect. My expectation is the captive set free. Is that the chains that are holding us back be broken, Father. But I pray that you just move in this house, Father. We give you all control and all the glory and all the honor. In Jesus' name, amen.
we need to stay right here for a second. Stay right here for just a second. Can you give me that beat back, Dennis? Just a little kick. We're going to do this, church. Say hallelujah.
Yes. He's alive. He's alive.
Come on, just the voices.
Hallelujah.
He's alive.
He is alive.
He's alive.
He is alive.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He is alive.
He's alive.
He is alive.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on, somebody. He's alive.
He is alive.
He is alive.
He is alive. Hallelujah.
He's alive.
He is alive. He is alive.
Church that's just a little bit crazier than the church down the road. Can we be that church this morning? Somebody needs a crazy amount of faith in here. Come on, dance. Hey, hey, I'm asking all of my musicians, all my singers, come on, feel that. Church this morning. I think I heard five people. Anybody ready to go to church this morning?
Amen.
Hold up. For a second there, I thought we'd just step back a little bit. If somebody wants to have church in here.
We've come to praise Him.
And lift His holy name.
And lift His holy name.
I need somebody's help right here. Oh. doing right now. If you're on the camera, if you're on the soundboard, if you're on a lighting console, you ought to praise him. 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 Come on, you ought to praise him.
You ought to praise him.
If you're sitting at home right now and your husband's looking at you like you're crazy,
make a joyful noise.
Pastor Blake, what can we do to get the church ready? What can we do to get them back to Pentecostal? You know what I'm saying? What can we do? Well, it's songs like this, church. It's songs like this that were written down with a spirit behind them. With a spirit behind them. Not just lyrics. Spirit behind them. When you say, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back what is done. Are you going to war? Is anybody going to war in here? Because that's a war cry. That's a war cry. So, I don't need to boost you up anymore. I don't need to pat you on the butt anymore and say, good job. Nah, you need to go to war right now. And not some kind of war you fought 20 years ago. You need to fight war today. So when we say we're going to the enemy's camp, can we make it more than just lyrics? And my brother JJ has already got the message, so I don't need to speak to him. He began to move. He began to do some things in this sanctuary. Y'all saw him. I got my dancers up here with me. But I feel like there's some dancers, there's some people that need to step on the enemy this morning and need to come out of their seats and need to come out of their shells and they need to go to war this morning. Well, I went to the enemy's camp and I took back my soul. Come on, step out, step out, step out. Dennis talking about, my brother Derek, one of them Alexanders. I want you to stop on the kick real quick. No kick. All right. So Dennis is playing. I don't know if y'all know anything about the drums, but Dennis is playing that foot kick. All right. So the Lord just told me to prophesy over some things.
Come on now.
And I feel like there's some situations in this building. Somebody in this building just this week got a negative doctor report. And I'm not talking about Pastor. I promise there's somebody else in this. There's somebody in this room that caught a negative doctor's report recently. Alright? And you're thinking, oh, it wasn't me. I'm good. That's fine. It's not you. But I'm going to tell Dennis to get back on this kick in just a minute. Because I believe that it's going to break that thing loose in the spiritual realm. So So church, if that's you, yes, you got a reason to praise. Yeah, you got a reason to want that thing to be broken off. But if that is not you, then I need you to celebrate somebody's victory. Somebody's victory over that negative doctor's report. Are you ready? Dennis, are you ready? Come on. Hey, hey. Testify, say, can you believe what the Lord has done in me? What did you do, church? Say,
He saved me, cleansed me, turned my life around, set my feet upon the solid ground.
Can you believe it?
Can you believe what the Lord has done in me?
Come on, church. Can you believe it?
Can you believe what the Lord has done?
Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor.
Save me,
cleanse
me,
turn my life.
keep talking. I hate it. I hate to keep talking. I know y'all don't believe it, but I hate to keep talking. Right before we took off into that again, we had something. And we got to go back. We got to go back. We got to go back. Can we go back? Can we just real softly, whatever y'all was doing before? And I begin to hear people like Carrie begin to speak out in the spiritual realm. And then I begin to hear Jill speak out in the spiritual realm, Pastor. And it just started to break some stuff loose in me. Can we go back there? Can we go back there? I don't want to miss it. I don't want to miss the Lord. I don't want to miss it by trying to perform. I don't want to miss it. So can you just speak to your Father in heaven? We're going to let it sit, church. We're going to let it sit. As we move on to the next song, can you just begin to speak? Don't stop just because I stop.
Yeah.
talking to Jesus. She got me talking to Jesus. Yeah, my mama was right. Yeah, yeah. 'Cause now I'm talking to Jesus. Yeah, I love talking to Jesus. I'll be talking to Jesus for the rest of my life. Can we all together sing this? What a friend we have.
And what a friend we have in Jesus.
Yeah.
And what a friend we have in Jesus. What a friend we have in Jesus. Whoa.
Sing it again. What a friend we have.
What a friend we have in Jesus.
Come on. This is your song, church. This is your song, too.
What a friend.
What a friend.
What a friend we have in Jesus. Whoa.
Some of you can relate here.
I've got three of my own now. I'm trying to raise them upright.
You know what I'm talking about?
And my oldest is 6 years old. And I remember what that was like. Oh, trying to deal with the drama. Trying to figure out the questions in life.
Yeah.
I've been looking for a way to show him how to make it all right. But then he walked in my room while I was saying prayers the other night. He said, I'll come back later. I can tell you got a lot on your mind. But I said, you know it's not an interruption.
No, no, no.
You couldn't have picked a better time. Because I was just talking to Jesus. Come over and give it a try.
Yeah. Listen, church.
We started talking to Jesus. We started talking to Jesus. We started talking to Jesus.
Church, and now he's talking to Jesus,
and my son's talking to Jesus, and I hope he's talking to Jesus for the rest of his life. Say, what a friend we have,
yeah. What a friend we have in Jesus.
What a friend we have.
What a friend we have in
what
Jesus.
There's no wrong way to do it, church.
Nuh-uh.
And there's no bad time to start.
And you know, church,
it don't have to sound pretty. Just tell him what's on your heart.
I like this right here.
Because it's not a religion. It's more like a beautiful friendship. Oh, just talk to your father with such faith like you are his kid.
Come on, church.
Just start talking to Jesus.
Yeah, yeah.
Just start talking to Jesus. Oh, you can talk to Jesus whenever you like. Just start talking to Jesus.
Come on.
Just start talking to Jesus. Just keep talking to Jesus for the rest of your life.
Come on, talk to Jesus.
I cannot live without you. Can't imagine my life without you. There is no life without you.
Jesus, you're my life.
Jesus, you're my life.
Sing it again. I cannot live.
I cannot live without you. Can't imagine my life without you. There is no life.
Jesus, you're my life.
Jesus, you're my life.
Sing it again.
I cannot live without you.
Just like that.
Can't imagine my life without you. There is no life without you.
Jesus.
Jesus, you're my life.
One more time. Come on, say, I cannot live.
I cannot live without you. Can't imagine my life without you.
There is no life.
There is no life without you.
Jesus, you.
Jesus, you're my life.
Can I say?
And you, Lord, are all I have. And you give me all I need. And my future is in your hands. Jesus, you're my life, and you, Lord, are all I have, and you give me all I need, yes. My future is in your hand. Jesus, you're my life. I cannot live.
I cannot live
touching my life. Future is in your hands. Oh, my future is in your hands. Ooh. I cannot live without. I don't want to take another step. To walk it out right now. So easy, Lord, for me to sing these songs. It's so easy, Lord, to find your presence here amongst your children. When God, I need you. God, I need you on a Tuesday. God, I need you on a Wednesday. I know you're so quick to supply me, Lord. It's what you say in your word. It's what you say in your word. You tell me you are everything I need. God, fix this broken man. God, fix this broken man. Oh, this wretched, wicked man. When I forget you, when I forget you, Lord, when I ignore your voice, forgive me, Lord. Find me here broken, Lord. Find me here broken, Lord. Incapable of fixing my own darkness, Lord. Oh, you know the things I hide. You know the things I keep secret, Lord. You know my other self. You see him, Lord. You see him, Lord. But God, you're not afraid and you're not ashamed of me. Lord, you're not ashamed to call me your son. You're not ashamed to call me one of your own. You're not ashamed to say, look, look, angels, there's my son, there's my child. You're not ashamed, Lord. You're not ashamed, Lord. You're still proud of me, Lord. You haven't given up on me, Lord. You're still proud of me, Lord. Still calling out to me. Still calling out to me. Holy Spirit, you're still calling out to your church. Holy Spirit, you're still calling out to those who would find themselves broken, who would find themselves weak, who would find themselves needy. You're still calling out. You are still calling out those who would hunger and thirst, those who would hunger and thirst, those who would hunger and thirst. Come, come to the table, come to the table, come to the table, come to the table. Oh, you who are heavy burdened. Oh, you are who are heavy burdened. Come to the table. Come to the table. Oh, come, come, come quickly. Come quickly, my child. Come quickly, my child. Come quickly, my child. Oh, he's still calling. He's still calling. He's still calling. He's still calling your name. He's still calling your name, yes, yes he is. He's still calling your name. He's still calling your name. He's still calling your name. Like he did so long ago. He's still calling your name. Take time to look upon you. Oh, we sit and we just wait for a while. Oh, Lord, come and have your way. Oh, Lord, come and have your way.
Have your way, Lord. Have your way.
such a holy moment.
He's calling his children.
Such a holy moment.
Calling you closer.
Right here, right now. Ooh, the Lord is telling you to receive that word.
Come closer.
That word, you just got it. Rhema word right now. Receive that word. It's for you, for right now.
I will give you rest.
Receive it.
Come closer.
Receive it. Oh, 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 oh. We receive everything you spoke in us, Lord. For some of us, it was such a long time ago. Oh, we receive every promise you gave. We receive it, we receive it. Oh,
oh, oh. Who are heavy and weary, come find rest in me. Come find rest in your Father. He's saying, come to him. Come to him.
You, Lord, are all I have, and you give me all I need. My future is in your hands. My Jesus, you're my life. And you, Lord, are all I have, and you give me all I need. And my future is in your hands. Jesus, you're my life. I cannot live without you. Can't imagine my life without you. There is no
life without you.
Jesus,
you're my life.
Imagine
my life without you. There is no life without you. Jesus, you're my life.
And you made a way when our backs were against the wall and it looked as if it was over. Lord, you made a way, and now we're standing here only because you made, Lord, you
made a way.
When our backs were against the wall and it looked as if it was over, Lord, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made, Lord, you made a way. Right here, right now, when our backs were against the wall and it looked as if it was over, Lord, you made a way. Now we're standing here and we're standing. You move mountains, you cause walls to fall with your power, perform miracles. There is nothing that's impossible. And we're standing here only because you may say, you move mountains, you cause walls to fall with your power. Perform miracles. Come on, sing it out. And there is nothing that's impossible. That's impossible. And we're standing here only because you. Come on, you move. You move mountains. Hey, you cause walls to fall with your power. standing here, and we're standing here only because, one more time, come on, and I'm standing here only because you made a way.
Come on, church, praise him, praise him, praise him. He made a way.
God, I'm standing right here because you made a way, Lord. I'm standing right here because you made a way. I may be looking at that mountain right now, and I don't see a way around it, Lord. But I'm standing right here because I know you're gonna make a way. You're gonna make a way. You're gonna make a way. Lord, the doctor says it's not possible. That mountain's too big to climb. Oh, but God, I know you made a way. I know you made a way. Oh, even right now, as we speak to that mountain, we say, mountain, move, mountain, move.
Somebody better celebrate that pathway. Somebody better celebrate that pathway. God has just made a way. Somebody better celebrate it. Somebody better celebrate it. Somebody better celebrate it. Somebody better celebrate it. Somebody better start walking it. Somebody better start walking it. Somebody better start walking it. Start walking. Start walking it. Come on, he made a way. He made a way. He made a way.
Backs were against the wall. Church, somebody walked in here, back against the wall. Nowhere else to go. Oh, nowhere else to go. But Pastor, I hear the Lord saying, look to the hills from which comes your help. Somebody say, my help comes from the Lord. My help comes from, somebody better start looking. Somebody better start looking.
Come on, look to that. Look to that hill. The man said, I don't know if y'all know how that works. God has been speaking this whole service.
Yes.
God has been speaking, and maybe some of you just haven't been able to put it together.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? You haven't been able to put it together. The mountain is still there. The man just spoke what God has been saying this whole service. He moved it to the left, and he spread it to the right.
made a way.
He made a way. He made a way. That wasn't just him coming up with something. That was the Lord saying, I just made a way.
Yes.
I just made a way. Oh, somebody better put an extra bit of praise. Turn that knob up. Turn that knob up. Turn that knob. I just made a way. The Lord's saying he just made a way. Oh, he just made a way. Oh, yeah, your back was against the wall. You didn't have anywhere else to go. You didn't have any. You're right. You're right. You didn't have any other way to go. But today, what is today's date? The third, something, 30, something. Oh, Lord, it's May already. Today, May 2nd, he just made a way. I feel like, I'm sorry, Pastor. I feel like somebody should just pick up your phone and say, May 2nd, write a note, write a reminder, yearly reminder. I don't know. May 2nd, God made a way. Because you came in here, right? You came in here with your back against the wall. But God just made a way. I'm so thankful, church. So thankful. Some of you were too proud to realize that your back was against the wall. You're still clawing up the mountain. You're still trying to, but today, May 2nd, you realized your back was against the wall. And God made a way. God made a way. Hallelujah, Pastor, I'm done.
So Miss Lisa, when I can I get more into monitors? Miss Lisa, so when I got home last night and I went to bed, when I woke up this morning, I was spending time with him. I was looking through some text messages. Some of you didn't get text back to this morning because I was in a different place last night. But I ran across your picture where the guy was tilling the ground. And God spoke to me so plain. He said, I've already done this. He said, now the harvest is coming.
Yes.
But watch this. Listen. And we I'm not even worried about this today. Listen. You can't rush God. You can't stop him. You can't. But I was sitting there and God said, get on your knees. He said, I have a word for you. And when I got on my knees and your grandma began to pray, I know it was God because not anyone knew some of what I'm dealing with. But I knew it was God speaking. But Miss Shirley, he took me somewhere when I was, he said, you have the ability to either sit there between the two soldiers or you have the ability to get out. And he said something to me so plain. He said, we get comfortable in those that were brought forth to hold us down.
Yes. That's a good word.
He said we get comfortable because this is where we are. But some of you looking like you don't understand. I'm talking about Peter when he was in jail and there was 14 soldiers. He said we get comfortable. The Bible says that Peter did what? Peter went to sleep. The night before, Miss Shirley, he was supposed to be executed. How do you go to sleep the night before? And some may say, well, he trusted God that much. Pastor Blake, I'm going to be honest. I've got all the faith in the world. I'm telling you, I trust God for everything there is. But I've got something I'm getting ready to go up against in a few weeks. And guess what? Even my faith is shook. And every now and then, I got to remind myself that God is able. So to tell me that I'm supposed to die tomorrow, and I'm going to sleep with that verdict that has been on me, chained to two soldiers. God said, no, he wasn't resting in me. He was defeated. And he accepted what was said and what was in front of him. He came to be at peace, knowing that I was going to die tomorrow. Because guess what? I've watched my Savior be crucified. I've watched this one be crucified. I've watched this one die. So this is my fate. This is what's going to happen to me. He sat there. He accepted it. I'm speaking to about 10 of you right now. You don't have to accept what's been said. Yes. You don't have to accept what the doctor said. You don't have to accept what your parents said about you. You don't have to accept what your spouse said about you. How long will you sit here, chained between two soldiers, resting in what God can deliver you from? How long will you sit here and accept what a doctor says when God says I'm the ultimate physician? How long will you accept? Pastor Blake, your mother came to me and I didn't know what God was doing, and I'm going to give her an opportunity one day real soon to share, but she shared a testimony about you and what happened when you were little about your heart. Look at you now. You do not have to accept what's been diagnosed. You don't have to accept what's in front of you. You don't have to accept what your credit says. You don't have to accept none of that. You can change it right now. Because God will make a way. God, you speak to yourself. God, this ain't where I'm supposed to be. You know what? That's fine. We'll do that next week. I love this part of that story. The Bible says as he rested, Christ came to him, Pastor Blake, and nudged him. I know some of you are struggling right now. But if I'm chained between Brittany and Tiffany and JJ's God, the angel, and he comes and says, Mark, wake up. There's no way for him to speak to me. And they not here. But the Bible says when he spoke to Peter, that Peter opened his eyes. But that's not all that happened. The Bible says that the two chains that were, when the angel opened his mouth, the chains fell. I know some of you can't catch that. What am I trying to tell you today? If you open your mouth, angel, all you gotta do is open your mouth. If you open your mouth, guess what? The chains will. Watch this. Pastor Blake, they can't get excited like we get excited sometimes. Because you knew the story. You knew you weren't supposed to be doing all that. So when you don't do it, it reminds you where God had brought you from. So you got, I gotta act crazy, mama, because you know all that I've been through and all that's been said and all that tried to defeat me. Why am I saying this? Pastor Blake, when God, when the angel spoke to Peter, only Peter got up. Why? Because it was meant for Peter.
Whoa. That's right.
Not everyone's gonna be able to rejoice when you say a word, because guess what? It was spoken to you. I don't know why I'm going here, but we're getting ready to go here, and then we're going to sing a song. We're going home. The Bible says when Christ spoke, when God spoke to Adam, that the angel went, that the deceiver went to Eve. And deceiver went to Eve. And some may say, why was Adam so blind to what the deceiver did? The Bible says that a snake showed up. But what we didn't understand is that the snake itself had not been evil. The enemy did not show up as the enemy. The enemy showed up as a girlfriend. The enemy showed up as a co-worker. Oh, I'm getting ready to hurt someone. The enemy showed up as a church member. And guess what we did? We let our guard down. But watch this. The Bible says that Eve began to eat. Nothing happened when Adam ate. That's when it happened. Why? I'm getting ready to speak to some men right now and some folks that are putting pressure on others. The mandate was not made on her. The mandate was made on him. And when a mandate's made on me, I automatically make a mandate on my wife. But guess what? The mandate was not on my wife. It was on me. What are you trying to say? There's things that my wife can do that I can't do. I just went too deep for someone. Why? Because God spoke something to me, Leanne. I got a way of separating us from folks because he spoke something into us. And when he speaks it into us, he won't go with us. I hear God say, stop trying to drag people when I'm trying to release you from people. Peter, let those chains go. And I'm ending with this right here so that we can rejoice. Yes, this is fine. Some say, but why are we ending early? Because I believe that the work was done in praise and worship. I'm not that preacher that got to sit up here and make it about me. Guess what? The praise and worship was enough. But I want to end you with these words right here. The Bible says, even in that story, and I'll get there a little bit more next week. The Bible says, even in that story that Peter got outside the gate. And when he got outside the gate, he didn't try to run to get something to eat. He didn't try to get sushi, crab legs. When he got out of prison, speaking into your home right now. When he got out of prison, his first move was to go to the house of prayer. Because when God delivers you from prison, you can't forget what God has done for you. So your first move should be to run to the house. So that's why when we come in here, we act the way we act. That's why they jump the way they jump. Because you don't know the prisons that we've been in last week. So I'm going to say this to New Image. Run to the house. 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 Run. And guess what? When you get there, don't stop knocking. Don't stop knocking. Oh, someone looking at me like, what is he talking about? You'll have to come back next week to get the full understanding of it. But Miss Lisa, when Peter got to the house, the Bible says that he knocked at the gate. Some said he knocked at the door. But he knocked at the gate.
Okay.
The there's a difference between knocking at the door and knocking at the gate. There's some things happening in the parking lot here, and we're talking about putting up a gate.
Come on now.
The gate itself is not this door.
That's right.
The gate is the entryway to the property.
Yes.
So I'm going to ask the question, how in the world is Peter knocking at the gate and those in the house are hearing him? Peter's not knocking like you're knocking when you say you want deliverance.
That's right.
Peter ain't knocking like...
No.
I don't want to wake no one. They may hear me. People are looking at me. I look silly. They gonna talk about me after service. I'm used to being in control. Peter ain't knocking like that. Peter saying, you know what? I gotta get out of this thing. You better open. So can you do me a favor as the praise team? Help us to rock out of here. And whoever's about to take over for the rest of this service. Can you act like you want to get out of something? Can you act like you want to get out of something? Maybe not. Maybe not. Can you act like you want to get out of something? You're at the gate. You got to get the attention. Can you make some...